for the singing of the national anthem.
I guess the DJ doesn't have it.
Let us pray. Good, great, and loving God, our Father who art in heaven, we thank you for the completion of another academic year and for giving us the opportunity, short though may have been, to play a part in the lives of every student and our new graduates. We're grateful for your guidance and love as we share in this important work. Please bless and guide our graduates as they reach this end, as they chart a new beginning. May they have learned by being here and allow them to truly be women and men for others. May what they have learned will enable them to be great and powerful men and women. Help them, Heavenly Father, to use all that they have learned here to make a world a better place, to serve others in true solidarity and kinship, to seek ways to help the poor, the marginalized, and those who are suffering, and to always seek the greater good. We know that some of them will experience pain and hardship, and we know that some of them already have. And we ask you to grant them solace and strength. Finally, Father, we thank you for giving us the opportunity to build our community with these young men and women while they were here. Though they are leaving this campus, we know that they will always be with us, be a part of us, of the Mississippi Valley State University family. And we ask that the bonds that they have created here remain strong despite any distance that may come in between. Father God, we ask this in your name and in the name of Jesus Christ, the anointed one, your son. And the people of God says, amen, amen, amen and amen.
Ready! Good morning. It is indeed a beautiful morning to be with. Mississippi Valley State University, it really is. A beautiful morning. I am Dr. Jerryl Briggs, the blessed president, eighth president here at Mississippi Valley State University. And it is my privilege to preside over this commencement convocation to salute the outstanding class of 2022. But before we get to them, and we will get to them, I'd like to take an opportunity to recognize all of us here today. So to the parents, grandparents, children, spouses, aunts, uncles, relatives, and significant others who have gone above and beyond in supporting our graduates in so many ways, would you please stand and be recognized? Also, please join me in thanking the MVSU faculty who were on the front lines of teaching, nurturing, advising, challenging, and counseling these graduates to assure that they were well prepared to receive these degrees and equipped to take their place in society. Faculty, would you all please stand? And graduates, turn around and give them a round of applause. I would also like to show appreciation and recognition for staff and the executive cabinet who inspired and supported our graduates. Would you all please stand? Again, let's give them a round of applause. To the MVSU alumni who continuously support our students with their time, talent, and gifts. Would all the alumni please stand? Let's give them a round of applause. And to our commencement committee and all who had a diligent role in this activity today, would you all please stand? Let's give them a round of applause. And I'd also like to take an opportunity to recognize any local, state, or national elected officials who've joined us here today. Would you all please stand? So give them a round of applause. Now, the class of 2022, today we encourage you to enjoy this accomplishment that you've achieved. For this is a tremendous milestone in your life. And a major step in starting and continuing your career. So let's get it out. Let's go ahead. The class of 2022, would you all please stand? Stand, please. To my left, we have Ms. Eva Baeza our commencement speaker. Lieutenant Colonel Stephen Robinson, Chair of the Department of Military Science and Professor of Military Science, Army ROTC, Jackson State University. Ms. Augusta Wallace, our Chief of Staff. Ms. Joyce Dixon, our Vice President for Business and Finance and our Chief Financial Officer. Mr. Jeffrey Loggins, Director of Student Records and University Registrar. Dr. Kathy Golden, our Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs. Reverend Dr. Alice Hubbard Crenshaw, Pastor of the Turner Chapel African Methodist Episcopal Church. Dr. Thomas Calhoun Jr., our Vice President for Enrollment Management and Student Affairs. And Mr. Jerry Redmond, President, MVSU National Alumni Association. And Mr. George Ivory, our Interim Director of Athletics. Folks, let's give them a round of applause. At this time, we pause to celebrate the accomplishments and beginnings of the cadets that have met the requirements of the United States Army, Charles Robinson and Imani Walker. These individuals have a deep commitment to serving others and their country. They have not only met the requirements of the United States Army, but I am proud to say that they have successfully met the requirements of their degree. Congratulations, and may God continue to bless and keep you as you work to protect your fellow man and our country. Lieutenant Colonel Stephen Robinson, please come to the podium. Lieutenant, can you come up to the front?
After me, I state your full name. Having been appointed to an officer in the United States Army, and the grade of second lieutenant, do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same, and I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion. And I will well and faithfully discharge the duties of the office which I'm about to enter. So help me God. Hey, congratulations to Lieutenant Robinson and Lieutenant Walker. I'm extremely proud of you. Always remember, take care of yourself, your soldiers, and your families. Good luck, Godspeed, Hoor.
As they walk, let's give them another round of applause. Thank you. Congratulations. We will now have the introduction of our commencement speaker, Dr. Kathy Strohmile Golden, Provost Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs.
Good morning again. I have the honor and privilege of introducing your 2022 Spring Commencement Speaker. Ms. Eva Baeza is an award-winning playwright, director, composer, novelist, and educator. A finalist for the 2020 Herb Eckert Award in Theater and the 2020 Francesca Primus Prize. Baeza was the inaugural humanist in residence at the National Endowment for the Humanities and a 2022 McDowell Fellow. She works for both a creative nonfiction and fictional lens to explore pivotal intersections of race throughout history and in the present. Her critically acclaimed drama, The Ballad of Emmett Till, received a Eugene O'Neill National Playwright Conference Fellowship and premiered in the Goodman Theater in Chicago in 2008, winning the Mystery Writers of America Edgar Award for Best Play. The Ballad made its West Coast premiere at the Fountain Theater in Los Angeles in 2010, garnering 6 Ovation Awards, including Best Production, the Drama Desk Critic Circle Award for Best Production, and the Backstage Garland Award for Best Playwriting. Celebrated productions followed with the Houston Ensemble Theater, Penumbra Theater, Renaissance Theater Works, and Ion Theater, where it earned top honors at the San Diego Critics Circle Craig Noel Awards, including Outstanding Dramatic Production. Baeza has expanded The Ballad of Emmett Till into the Till Trilogy, recounting the epic civil rights saga, now in 3 distinct dramas. The Ballad of Emmett Till deals with the journey of the boy himself, That Summer in Sumner, on the trial of his killers is seen through the eyes of a team of black reporters and benevolence, on the event's deep impact on the Mississippi Delta in the aftermath of Till's death. Through a generous grant from Roy Cochran Foundation, Mosaic Theater Company of D.C. will mount the Till Trilogy in its entirety in the fall of 2022, with all 3 plays running a repertory, and That Summer in Sumner making its world premiere. Baeza received funding from the National Endowment for the Humanities for the Works Development and from the National Endowment of the Arts for the upcoming production, the first mounting of the seminal work in the nation's capital. Other innovative works for this stage include Homer G. and the Rhapsodies in the Fall of Detroit, which is a Kennedy Center Fund for New American Plays Award. String Theory, a Brown University Commencement production. Welcome to Wonderland, a fictional autobiography adaptation of Wallace Thurman's Harlem Renaissance classic, Infants of the Spring. Intozaki Shange's A Photograph, Lovers in Motion, and the Islamic passion play, Tazia, Between Two Rivers, as well as original full musicals, Charleston O'Leo, Bonk Johnson, A Blues Poem, and Kid Zero. She is co-authored with her sister, Intozaki Shange, The Gorgeous, which is printed in the New York Times, Magical L, Dazzling Essence, and novel Some Sing, Some Cry, chronicling 200 years of African-American music through 7 generations of women. Currently, through a commission from the National Trust for Historic Preservation, she is an artist in digital residence, guiding a group of 11 writers and reimagining the history and future of sugarcane plantation Home Shadows on the Teach in New Iberia, Louisiana. In addition, she has been commissioned to create 2 Underground Railroad dramas for Children's Theater Company and Penumbra Theater in Minneapolis and St. Paul, Minnesota, respectively. She is writing the theater for young audiences, Beaudon's Brahman drama, One Small Alice, concerning a young girl's solo quest for freedom through the American wilderness on the eve of the Civil War, and for a consortium of organizations at Oberlin College in Oberlin, Ohio. She is also creating an outdoor drama based on the 1858 Oberlin Wellington Rescue, one of the most notorious anti-slavery battles of the 19th century. A distinguished visiting scholar and artist in residence at Brown University, she is a cum laude graduate of Harvard University with an MFA in directing and dramaturgy from the University of Massachusetts at Amherst. Please welcome our speaker.
Thank you, Provost Dr. Golden, for that most generous introduction. Thank you, President Briggs. And good morning. Mississippi Valley State University graduating class of 2022. And to all of your family and friends who have come here to celebrate you today, I got to tell you that it was truly wonderful. It's truly wonderful to be here live and in person, and such an honor to be commencement speaker, to see all of your beautiful faces and those smiles, and to congratulate you on the completion of this part of your life's journey and the commencement of another. I confess I struggled with what to say today. These are difficult times. Every day, it seems, there are things that we never expected to see, and things that we never expected to see again. In preparing my remarks, I thought about the beginning of this institution, Mississippi Valley State University, and its original mission to train teachers on how to bring up the next generation of the young, gifted, and Black in this fine state. How many future teachers do we have in this graduating class and audience today? Thank you. On behalf of America's children, thank you. I see that the mission is still strong. The challenge was great when MVSU was founded in 1950, when we as Black people had been so long denied access to learning that we would foster an institution to nurture our own army of teachers. But what an odd time to be a teacher. It's a challenge that seems still as great. Take language, for instance. The N-word is banned, and yet the words critical race theory and woke are spewed out with the same venom. To my ear, it's with an inflection that feels poisonous and menacing, with the implicit suggestion that there is something wrong with the study of America's racial history and the role that race has played in our history, or any history for that matter. You know, back in the 1850s, there was a party, a political party, that called themselves the Know-Nothings. Ignoring the issue of slavery altogether, they dedicated themselves to the freedom of white men. Organization replete with conspiracy theories, secret symbols, and paranoia such that if anyone asked them or queried about their affiliation, they would say, "We know nothing." Think about that. My goodness, if ever there was a case of history repeating itself, look at what's happening today. Know-nothings, apparently they're back, denying science, denying history, banning books in hopes that the rest of the public will remain as ignorant and as small-minded as they apparently are. We know nothing. A nation of know-nothings. Imagine. That's why this day, Your day is so important. The celebration of your completing this course of higher knowledge, aiming, arming yourself against the know-nothings. People who would have you believe that their children are too sensitive to hear difficult truths and too delicate to ponder controversial ideas. When it is our children, black, brown, and poor children, who are the most vulnerable, our children who are being gunned down in the streets, our children whose minds are constantly assaulted by a culture denying their beauty and brilliance, as fiercely as it denies our unequivocal contributions to the making of this nation. People would have you believe that their objective is freedom, when the opposite is true. Some people in their streams seek to ban even the discussion of race or enslavement because it makes their children feel bad. It should make us all feel bad. But I can sign, but simultaneously, it should be instructive and inspiring. The persistent, inventive, and inviolable efforts of Black Americans and their allies to eradicate step by painful step that terrible practice of enslavement and its ugly and ongoing legacy lurking behind the manicured lawns of plantation home tour sites and laws still on the books from slave owners. The surveillance, the irritation too often expressed at the thought that Black lives matter. Freedom, sovereignty, and identity, these are difficult subjects to reckon with. I mean, you all just finished 4 years of toil, right? That was hard work. Tell me if I'm wrong. But learning isn't always supposed to make you feel good. Well, when you turn in a paper or solve that impossible equilibrium problem or defended your thesis successfully, yeah, maybe then. But the rest of the time, it's hard work. When you make a brilliant comment in class, or you ace that test, yeah, it makes you feel good, but the rest of the time it's hard work. You gotta absorb new ideas. You gotta figure things out. You have to study, you need to research. You gotta ponder conflicting notions. To solve problems, you've gotta be able to exercise the muscles of your mind. Stretch it to make it supple. Lift some weights to make it strong. Get oxygen out there. Work out. Can we hold two ideas in our minds simultaneously, for instance? 1619 is as important a symbolic year as 1776. Is that so difficult? Can we season our meals, our food for thought, with both salt and pepper? History has its ebb and flow. It's a kind of dance. One step forward, two steps back. I don't know where the dance is going right now. Somebody's standing on my toe. Our democracy is in trouble. And yet, look how much we sacrificed for it. How much we fought and lost for it. How much we gained from it. How much we have given to it. You are coming of age in a trying time. It has been a whirlwind since you got here. The 2001 Act of Foreign Terror so stunned our nation, was followed by a great recession, and then one glorious dawn of seeing an African-American elected to the highest office of the land, only to watch that very same nation contract with a severe affliction of dis-ease, of willful ignorance, and then the pestilence, leaving no mark on the skin, but marking the landscape with a million graves. This whirlwind is not unlike the one I'm writing about now, the 1850s into the Civil War and the first years of Reconstruction, where we saw the legal end to enslavement, followed by the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments establishing sovereignty of our bodies and equality under the law. In the wake of that Civil War, under a grand plan of Reconstruction, reconstructed justice, we saw the first system of universal public schools, the universal male right to vote, access to elected office, Mississippi produced its first, and as yet, only Black Senator Blanche K. Bruce. Black Reconstruction, as it recounted with immaculate research by our preeminent scholar W.E.B. Du Bois, was a time of glorious achievement. But that dawn, that moment of light, too, was extinguished through campaigns, night riders, government collusion, backroom bargaining, allowing the paragons of slavocracy to assume power again, introducing 100 years of terror hiding beneath the euphemistic name of Jim Crow, a name stolen from a crippled Black itinerant performer on the streets of Baltimore, his name and identity, even his clothes, stolen and transmuted by a rather mediocre actor named James Rice into America's first form of bona fide popular entertainment, the multi-million dollar enterprise of Blackface minstrelsy, giving its name to a system of suppression and oppression that lasted over 100 years. Mississippi, a state that elected a Black senator, Blanche K. Bruce, in 1875, by 1964 had only 70% of Black people eligible to vote registered. And yet today, Mississippi has more Black elected officials than any other state in the nation. So, how do you teach these varying ideas? How do you teach with open access to ideas? Let me talk about an idea, a marvelous idea, a declaration to the world that all men are created equal and endowed by their creator with certain unalienable rights, and among those rights are life, liberty, and that odd phrase, the pursuit of happiness. Although the writer of this remarkable sentence didn't himself practice it, the idea took on breath and life of its own. And no Americans have responded more acutely to it than those enslaved, denied access even to the rudiments of education in an environment where the study of ideas was forbidden. They inherently knew its truth. The actions of Black Americans over the centuries have constantly and persistently and fervently pushed and challenged this nation, as one of the characters in that play says. Push this nation, dragging, kicking, and screaming toward its rocks. That essay, that one phrase. Throughout my career as a writer and educator and activist, I've been chronicling my people. With my sister, the renowned poet and Saki Shange, I co-authored the novel Something Samurai, chronicling 200 years of our music through a fictional story. What a joy and a revelation to map the remarkable history of Black American sonic genius. From spirituals to hollas to work songs, from blues to ragtime, from jazz to big bands, to bebop and R&B and its stepchild rock and roll. From free jazz to freestyle, to hip hop, which has become the language of youth, around the world, from Korea to Cuba, from South Africa to Sweden. All of these forms were birthed by the ethos of Black people. In Welcome to Wonderland, I mapped out my experience with desegregation and waiting around versus the Board of Ed, my understanding of conflicting truths and beliefs. No Wonderland, the Civil War was not fought over slavery, it was fought over state rights. I made an enemy for life of my fifth grade teacher, Mrs. Mangan, when I asked her, "States' rights to do what?" And then there was Enid. My research on developing the Till Trilogy is what brought me here to Mississippi originally. While I knew the story through books and magazines, I wanted to bear witness myself. I was curious about the boy, the youth, the agency of youth, the role he himself played in the saga that bears his name. I discovered that while his mother is to be heralded for insisting that they have an open casket funeral, sparking a national outcry that launched the modern civil rights movement, he was as much a change agent as she. Youth like yourselves have been at the center of all of our advances. They tried to make his body disappear, to excise him by sinking his body in the river with a 90-pound gin fan. I know they didn't realize the power of spirit. Weighed down with a gin fan attached with barbed wire, they expected his body to disappear. Instead, it rose up, feet first. The body rose up. Such was the power of spirit. Such was the urge to cry for justice. Such was the spirit of that youth that he would not be denied. The trial and acquittal of his killers lasted 5 days. 67 years later, finally, we have a federal anti-lynching statute named in the honor of Emmett Till. Passed by a recalcitrant Congress, but 157 years after emancipation, and tens of thousands of bodies later. This soil, this black soil, is rich in blood and history. George Floyd, Freddie Gray, Trayvon Martin, Sandra Bland, Medgar Evers, George Lee, Lamar Smith, Fannie Lou Hamer, Jamie Goodwin Turner, Freedom Summer, our black Camelot bound bayou, found a dusty hamlet. Emmett's killers were never brought to justice. How is that a legacy, you ask? How is that rich? What that power has meant to our people, and what has that power meant for our people, for the nation, and for the world? And what does it offer you? What to tell you in times like these? Look to our history. In every category, politics, political movement, social movements, culture, popular culture, language, science, agriculture, engineering, military, religion, music, dance, culinary arts, and perhaps all the family activism. All this, a wellspring, despite the efforts of suppression and oppression and erasure and violence and exploitation, we persist with this magnificent thirst and hunger for that idea, for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. We have made it manifest through our deeds. We have made it palpable through and in our person. For all of the great names surrounding, supporting you, lifting us up, for all of the great names that we remember and know, there are millions of anonymous souls of black folk that are here with you today because they dreamed you up. They lived and died and sacrificed and loved and schemed and invented and enabled and imagined and conjured you up. And the ground beneath our feet and the ether above our heads, there in the blood flowing through your veins, in the rivers from the waters from which we drink. In that turn of phrase, in that intuitive moment, that shock of a new idea, in that swag and in our style and in our audacity to believe that we matter. This knowledge is evidence of your presence. That logos, that ethos, that love that entitles you to all the promise that this nation has to offer. You were the future that they fought and died and lived for. The fact that you are here today is a living testament. You are their dream. That bounty is infused in your blood to buoy your spirit through dark nights. As as black people, descendants of the once enslaved, your very heritage is rich beyond imagining. Those who deny it, casting it as a history that makes their children feel bad, or makes our own children feel perpetually downtrodden, are so misguided and mistaken. The opposite is true. How is it a legacy? And what are you to do with it, you say? I'm going to answer with a closing anecdote from my youth, a test I failed quite royally. The question it took me 40 years to answer, a pop quiz. It took me 40 years to pass. Like you all, in a few minutes, I had just graduated college. My dad took me on a ride. He said for my graduation present, I thought I would get in cello. Instead, we set out of our suburban ranch house in New Jersey and drove for hours into the Pennsylvania Dutch country. It was dark by the time he turned his black Cadillac off the road onto a dirt path of the training camp of the world champion, heavyweight champion, Muhammad Ali. I'm like, what? Full disclosure, my dad is a boxing aficionado, a practicing surgeon. He was ringside physician on the side as a hobby. I had been meeting boxers and wrestlers all of my life, but I was totally unprepared for an audience with the greatest. I mean, I thought I was getting a cello. So I walk in, and he's sitting there in all of his majesty. I don't remember anything. I don't even remember being introduced. All I remember is that he asked me one question. Are you one? Well, I see myself more as one of the people I'm committed to the struggle, I said. Are you one in a million? I don't know how to answer that. I never thought of myself that way. Are you one in a million? I don't know. I just graduated. I blathered on and on trying to figure out how to answer and why you kept on asking it. Come on, I graduated from Harvard that I was. It took me 40 years to figure out the answer was yes. 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 So with great man's permission, thank you. I'm going to ask you the same question I said when he failed. Are you one of them? Never think of yourself as a servant, but always serve your people. Always have a sense of humor. Stay true to your heritage and to your vision. See yourself as the future. I see you. I have to put on my sunglasses because the shine is so bright. Your own unique way. Move this nation toward its promise and show the world once again how democracy is done. Congratulations, and now with my very best wishes for a lot of good luck.
choir. We can do better than that. Let's give her another round of applause. And Ms. Gaza, if you would join me back here at the podium. I'm pleased to present this plaque to you on behalf of the graduating class and all the faculty, staff, and students here at Mississippi Valley State University. And it reads, Mississippi Valley State University salutes Ms. Eva Beaza, keynote speaker, the 70th commencement ceremony, Dr. Jerryl Briggs, Senior, President, May 7, 2022. One goal, one team, one valley, in motion. All right, y'all ready? All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment for which we've all been waiting. It's honorable and most notable time for our graduates. I now invite Dr. Kathy Golden to join me for the presentation of candidates and conferring of master's degrees.
So the graduate for the Master of Science, Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, Master of Social Work, and Master of Arts and Teaching degrees, please stand. These candidates have completed all requirements for the Master of Science, Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, Master of Social Work, and Master of Arts degree in teaching. Therefore, based upon the recommendation of the faculty of the respective departments, I present them to you for the conferring of degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Mississippi Institution of Higher Learning, I do hereby confer upon you the Master of Arts, Master of Science, Master of Business Administration, Master of Social Work, and Master of Arts and Teaching degrees, with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. You may come forward to receive your degree as your name is called.
Administration.
Go, baby!
Tiffany L. Massey, Master of Business Administration. Pratisha K. Smith, Master of Business Administration. Jamara L. Jackson, Master of Business Administration. Brenda R. Jordan, Vondra K. Nitt, Master of Business Administration. Kevin I. Bracey, Master of Business Administration. Travis Hahn. Monika and Morgan, Master of Business Administration. Marcus A. Percy, Master of Business Administration. Tatika L. Port.
Yeah!
that do that day, Master of Science in Environmental Health.
Yes.
Raven L. Jones, Master of
ABC.
the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the departments of English and Foreign Languages, Fine Arts, Health, Physical Education and Recreation, Mathematics, Computer and Information Sciences, Natural Science and Environmental Health, and Social Sciences. Please stand.
Oh!
Daisy E. Pace, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration, Bachelor of Science, Accounting, Magna Cum Laude. Peyton A. Dunn, Bachelor of Science, Accounting, Cum Laude. Business Administration. Brianna R. Austin, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Cum Laude. Tynese Y. Brown, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Cum Laude. Mariel E. Quinn, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Magna Cum Laude. Caitlin A. Copeland, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice. Daquan T. Davis, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Magna Cum Laude. Jakayla Edwards, Criminal Justice, Cum Laude. Chandrika S. Gardner, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice. Miltiana R. Grace, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration, Summa Cum Laude. Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Summa Cum Laude. Shavanya M. Ivory Griffin, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice. Jerryl A. Tamara C. Watson, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice. Jakiria S. Ruffin, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice. Cedric B. Holt, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice. Taylor D. Payne, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Cum Laude. Ronnie L. Williams, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Magna Cum Laude. Deanna L. Bowden, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Cum Laude. Robinicia S. Burns, Bachelor of Science, Engineering Technology.
You made it,
Boston!
You made it!
Wesley G. Dinkins, Bachelor of Science, Engineering Technology, Cum Laude. Orlando E. Fernandez, Bachelor of Science, Engineering Technology, Summa Cum Laude. Bachelor of Science, Victoria C. Mallard, Bachelor of Science, Engineering Technology, Magna Cum Laude. Montez Penn, Bachelor of Science, Engineering Technology. Cameron E. Spencer, Bachelor of Science, Engineering Technology. James Thomas Watson, Bachelor of Science, Engineering Technology. J. Iris Hubbard, Bachelor of Arts,
simply be free. That's your promise. Demarcus A. McCall, Bachelor of Arts, Art, Summa Cum Laude. Malik Woods, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Chad V. Chang, Bachelor of James R. Chandler, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education, Magna Cum Laude. Deontay D. Justin L. Austin, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education, Magna Cum Laude. Caleb D. Johnson, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education. Tyus J. Lewis. Richard, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education, Summa Cum Laude. Lysandra D. Taylor, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education. Desmond L. Jordan, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education. Shakim A. Seymour, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education. Laney Taronis, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education. Brenny E. Thomas, Bachelor of Science, Health, Physical Education, Cum Laude. Raquel L. John A. M. Gardner, Bachelor of Arts, Communication. Keon Hill, Bachelor of Arts, Communication. Joshua W. King, Bachelor of Arts, Communication, Cum Laude. William R. Morgan, Bachelor of Arts, Communication, Cum Laude. Angel Perez, Bachelor of Arts, Communication, Summa Cum Laude. Michaela A. Geary, Bachelor of Arts, Communication, Cum Laude. Rasheed K. Scott, Bachelor of Arts, Communication. Jalen R. Smith, Bachelor of Arts, Speech, Mass Communication, Summa Cum Laude. Takia A. Wahan, Bachelor of Arts, Communication, Cum Laude. Andre E. Williams, Bachelor of Arts, Communication, Cum Laude. Antoine Williams, Bachelor of Arts, Communication. Shakira B. Holzer, Bachelor of Arts, English, summa cum laude. Hannah J. Wafer, Bachelor of Science, Mathematics, cum laude. Bachelor of Science, History, cum laude. Precious Idenin, Bachelor of Science, Mathematics, Magna Cum Laude, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science, Magna Cum Laude. Tawan L. Becker, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Anthony Moses III, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Philemon C. King, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Rosalind Shockey, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science, summa cum laude. Juan Spratton, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Sierra Stewart, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Jayshon Woods, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Mariah Santa Fe Bond.
Let's go,
Bachelor of Science, Biology.
Let's go,
Bachelor of Science, Biology.
slavery.
Chandra N. Young.
Bachelor of Arts, University Studies. Elena Milanis, Bachelor of Social Work, Magna Cum Laude. Tanisha D. Champion, Bachelor of Social Work, Cum Laude. Lena M. Hicks.
Bachelor of Science, Early Childhood Education, Magna Cum Laude. Hilton, Bachelor of Science, Early Childhood Education, Magna Cum Laude. Amy B. McCline Fitzgerald, Bachelor of Science, Elementary Education. Sharonda D. Jefferson, Bachelor of Science, Elementary Education. Renija J. Marisha Gill, Bachelor of Science, Elementary Education, Cum Laude. Dante Howard, Bachelor of Science, Elementary Education. Orlando Lezich, Bachelor of Science.
this time, we are delighted to recognize a special group of individuals who have the distinction of being our golden anniversary graduates. We have 20 members of the Mississippi Valley State University class of 1972 here with us today. Ms. Webb, please join us here on stage.
Miss Bergia May Brown, social studies. Miss Norma McIntosh Buckhalter, elementary education. Miss Lucille Smith Calvin, social science education. Miss Ann Corder, history. Miss Martha Davis, social science.
Woo!
And Ms. Gwendolyn Tripley, sociology.
$1 million annually to our great university. So, Madam Speaker, if I may, alumni, are you one in a million? We need you to renew your membership in 1 year and recruit one new alum every year. May you have a lifetime of success. You may now be seated. Congratulations.
Now I know you all are ready to celebrate. So my closing or charge to you will be brief. I started out by saying what? It's a beautiful day to be where? Mississippi Family State University. Wouldn't y'all all agree? This was a beautiful, beautiful ceremony. What I'm going to ask in charging y'all is to always remember today. Always remember the significance of what it meant for you to be here and for your family to be here as well. This is very, very special. You all have heard me talk about the book of life, that we each have a book, and we write that book of various chapters of our lives. And indeed, this is a chapter that you all will always cherish and remember. Because your experience here is getting lifelong friends. Friends that you met here in college will ultimately be your friends throughout your life. That's how special this opportunity is. That's how special this university is. So when we say that we are the best university in this country, it's because of things and opportunities like this. To grow, to believe, and to just love each other and love our institution. So now that you all are graduates, make sure that you display that diploma proudly. Proudly. So when folks look at it and say, where did you go to college? You say, I went to Mississippi Valley State University. Right? That's great. Let's do that. Let's do that. Because I always say, you know, if you love Mississippi Valley, and I know we all do, but if you truly, truly love Mississippi Valley State University, guess what? Mississippi Valley State University will always, always love you back. Always love you back.
And as we end, we're going to end with saying that eight-word vision that I know we all know. Because those are not just words. It's really about who we are and the importance of what you all are to our institution. So we are one goal, one team, one valley, in motion. In motion. So congratulations. This is again a blessed day, and we are just so proud of each and every one of you. Now as we end, we ask that everyone stand for the singing of our alma mater, which will be followed by the benediction. And after the benediction, please be seated for the reception. Thank you all again.
Their journey through life. May they find strength in the excellence of their academic preparation and the long line of educational tradition. Bless their lives from this day on with goodness and success. Enable them to stay true to their dreams for their greater glory. Enable them to use their gifts wisely in the service of others. Empower them to walk in the future with faith, hope, and great love, guided by your light so that they may use their talents to go forth and set the world on fire. Go out, graduates, enjoy as you celebrate your achievements here today. Go out with confidence, knowing that God, the love of God, will lead your way. Go out with wisdom as God renews your mind each day. Go out in love and kindness and blessings to give away. Go out and take your studies to bless God's beautiful word. Go out with freedom. There's so much more to see, enjoy, and learn. And now may the grace of God be upon all of you, my Father's children, and we say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
It'll be on the school's website.